Hello and welcome back to WordMA tutorial number 10. We will have a closer look at rhythm forces in this one. In contradiction to the former tutorials, I will show the basic cues in real time and then we jump into a previously created, more complex scene to explain what has been done there. Especially with forces, you can spend ages to tweak and this would be too boring to watch in a tutorial. In other words, get the basics here and then jump into your own experiments. I prepared a simple scene, which you might have seen in the tutorial teaser video. At this point, we do not have movement or rigging done yet. Just a character, an image panel as backdrop, and three colored spotlights linked to a cube. We can rotate the cube to move the lights around for a nice dance hall effect. Finally, we have behind us one more white point light for frontal illumination of the character. Okay, so enough small talk, let's go to work. In order to add an external audio track, we have to jump to the Scene Audio Control tab and paste a link to a MP3 or OGG file, either in the web or on the local hard disk. I copied the link to the clipboard in desktop mode and can now just paste it into the URL field. The green dot shows that the path is correct. I'm using an OGG file here as Unity can play this natively, while MP3 files are converted to WAV files before they play. The second thing needed is a rhythm force producer, which can be found in the force category. Third item needed is located in the sound category and is called Rhythm Audio Source. This is a special positional audio source for the Rhythm Force producer. And finally, we need a trigger to initiate the playback. Now we have all we need in the scene. The trigger object tells the rhythm audio source what, when, and how to play. The rhythm audio source controls the position from where the sound comes, the audio volume, and other audio settings. The rhythm force producer analyzes the playing audio, detects the beats, and creates forces out of the detected beats. Right, now we set up the trigger to control the audio source. Adding a start action, selecting Rhythm Audio Source, then we can select Play Now to play the audio track one time, or Play Now Loop to play the track over and over. We use external audio, so we choose URL, categories web, and the clip to play is our previously added OGG file. Quick test. Works. The trigger has to be activated by a physical object and it shall play right after the scene is loaded. We will place it into the nice table later. As said, the Rhythm Audio Source has several adjustments, for instance the volume and stereo spread. Last setting defines how far virtual stereo speakers are apart from the audio source center position. The audio source plays the music that we hear, so we should position it above the player position for best sound. Finally, we take care on the rhythm force producer. First, we need to define the audio source which it shall be linked to. We can have more than one audio source in the scenes, so this is an important selection. Then we set up the force section. The receiver shall be the character's hip node, as we want to animate the hip like this. The Rhythm Force producer behaves basically like a Cycle Force producer, which has been explained in detail in tutorial number 6. The torque factor twists around the long axis, so we set the orientation like this to get the desired move of the hip. Okay, now we select the hip as receiver. Last thing to make the character start moving is to actually play the music track. So we place the trigger into the fancy table object now. Great, some movement. But not really like we wanted, so we have to adjust the audio analysis parameters of the Rhythm Force producer. I will reduce the music volume for better understanding. First thing to do to get a more regular and beat-driven movement is to reduce the chance of 2 times burst value. Okay, that's better. The beat sensitivity adjusts the required sound level for the beat to trigger a movement. 100 will not produce any movement. 1 will be the most sensitive setting. The torque factor adjusts the force of the movement. More torque, more movement. In addition, we can adjust the physics settings of the surrounding active nodes. Reduced spring forces here result in a more dynamic movement. Not bad, is it? Let's add some more movements. As the beat detection eats up CPU power, I recommend to use SyncForce producers instead. To move the head naturally, we will target the neck for the movement. We need to sync the Sync Force producer to the Rhythm Force producer. Oops, looks a bit crappy. Reason is that the head holds the position while the neck tries to rotate. I will do a quick update to this. Important, as only the head node fixes the position of the whole upper body, always activate the new node, in this case the neck, before disabling the old node, in this case the head, or the character will collapse. Better. But too much movement now, so we reduce the torque setting. In order to adjust the force setting of the Sync Force producer independently, we need to remove the hook from Auto Sync. Adjusting torque. Looks a bit like a pendulum now. Let's invert the head movement. and add a bit side movement. Yes, that's better now. Okay, now we create a bit of a light show. We add another SyncForce producer, climb up to the cube, and position the SyncForce producer with the long axis facing to the cube center. Sync again to the RhythmForce producer and set the cube as receiver. Could be a bit more rotation, right? Torque setting is already quite high, so in this case we increase the mass of the cube a bit to get a more dynamic rotation. So, these are the basics. And now, as announced, let's load the more advanced scene from the teaser video. Right, let's see what we have. The whole body moves slightly up and down by an animation pattern, which is synchronized to the music. What? Synchronized animation patterns? Okay, here is what happens. The RhythmForce producer moves the hip synced to the beats, and the hip activates a collision trigger, which then triggers the animation pattern synced to the rhythm. Easy. But this little movement makes quite a difference. See by yourself in comparison when I switch it off. Furthermore, there is another animation pattern, which drives the first pattern downwards, to let the character go a bit down while dancing. This animation is triggered by timeline triggers. However, the way to go down is limited, as the collision trigger will not work anymore when the hip is out of its reach. Then for the arm animations, we have two separate animation patterns linked to the chest control. This ensures that the patterns move nicely with the body movements. The patterns are triggered by the timeline as well. In addition, there are two CycleForce producers which slowly rotate the hip and head independently around the vertical axis. This gives a more dynamic and diversified motion. But this was still not good enough, so I improved the scene further after the teaser video. Let's load the final version. Okay, here we have some more animations added. For instance, the head is looking downwards when triggered by timeline, and the VAM logo is jumping around on the table. Of course, everything in full sync with the music. But hey, where's the trigger on the side which drives the vertical pelvis animation? And what about the synced VAM logo movement?
Well, let me proudly introduce the latest breakthrough innovation of the JLFN laboratories to you. It is the RF Medic Rhythm Force Extender. Let me explain how it works.
Man, I'm so excited. Good old Steve must have felt similar when he presented the iPhone. Just kidding. The Rhythm Force Extender consists of a Rhythm Force producer and three collision triggers, which are activated by a moving cube. The cube is driven by the Rhythm Force producer, and so it is moving fully synchronized to the music. In other words, this little gadget allows to synchronize all actions which can be assigned to triggers with music. Means starting and stopping animations, switching lights, play other audio and so on. Basically, you can trigger things when there is no audio, so the cube is in center, or when audio starts, the cube leaves the center, and when each second beat reaches or leaves one of the outer triggers in exchange. As you can see, I create a strobe effect by quickly switching a light source on and off. And I play the pelvis animation pattern each time the cube leaves the outer trigger areas. For the colored light animations, I change from Rhythm Force to a more dynamic effect with combined animation patterns. The strobe effect gives enough reference to the music. Oh, there is also one additional collision trigger switching the strobe to give a semi-random effect. Okay, now let's enjoy one full dance cycle before we end this tutorial. it for now. See you next time, guys.